sadhu who was very famous and he had lots of disciples. So one day a very rich man walks in to his sermon, to his lectures. And then at the end, he comes and pays obeisances and he says, Sadhuji, I'm in problem. Can you help me? So he says, what help you require? So he said, well, I'm a big businessman. And because of this coronavirus lockdown, you know, my factory is closed and I have no money. So can you help me somewhere? So he said, what is your business? So he says, well, I produce oil. So he said, fine, you produce oil in the sense that means you must be having those big iron barrels where you store oil, you filter them and the whole process goes on. He says, yes. The sadhu says, very simple. I have a touchstone with me. So you go ahead, take this touchstone and the moment this touchstone touches the iron, they will be turned into gold. And your financial problem will be sorted out. So he was very happy. So he took the stone and he was very happy. He went home. And then he never came back. So the sadhu is waiting. This Sunday feast is over. The next Sunday feast is over. But he's not coming back. And after 6 months, the sadhu decided that I'll go and pay a visit to him. So sadhu goes and meets him. Now he's still in a very, miserable situation. And, you know, very sad. And when the sadhu walks in, he's not very respectful. So sadhu says, well, what exactly happened? I gave you the touchstone. So he said, yeah, I just lost faith on you. So he said, what did I do wrong? The sadhu asked. He said, you said that was a touchstone, but it didn't change nothing into gold. You know, my all iron barrels are still iron barrels. Nothing changed. The sadhu said, well, I gave you a genuine touchstone. And he said, well, if it is true, then why nothing changed into gold? Then he said, come on, can you show me where is that stone? Let me check. So he said, it's not with me. It's in my factory. So they all go to the place where this oil production happens. So sadhu says, where is the stone? So he said that these iron barrels are very huge, you know, very high and deep. So he said, I took a ladder and I threw the touchstone inside one of the barrels so that it turns into gold. So then sadhu says, which exactly, which barrel? So then they just climb up the ladder together and then they peep inside. And what the sadhu sees, this particular touchstone had never touched the iron. Why? Because of the lockdown, there was lots of cobwebs inside the iron barrel. So when he actually threw the stone was on the cobweb and it was hanging. It never touched the iron. So that's why it never turned into gold. So then the sadhu says, look here, you know, the touchstone hasn't even touched the iron and that's why it didn't touch into gold. And then he understands and then finally they have a solution. Now, why I gave this example is that I guess we also got something like a touchstone, like this Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. And sometimes we say, how come it just doesn't work? I mean, I've been chanting 10 years, 16 years. I know how come my problems are not sorted out or how come this or that. But probably there are so many cobwebs in our mind that it's not even touching us, right? We're not even doing it mindfully, you know? We're very mechanical about it. So, I mean, see, everywhere you see in the whole process of Krishna consciousness, the importance is given to the mind. Your mind has to be with Krishna. Krishna says, I want your mind, man mana bhava mad bhakto. So you have to give our mind to Krishna.
Sab Krishna, Krishna, Krishna lage. Sab Krishna, Krishna, Krishna lage. Sab Krishna, Krishna.